भगवद गीते ओम जय भगवद गीते हरि हिय कमल
विहारिणी
सुनर सुपुनि
You have the floor, Prof.
वसुदेव सुतं देवं कंस चाणूर मर्दनं देवकी परमानंदं कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुं एकं शास्त्रं देवकी पुत्र इज इट ओके एकं शास्त्रं देवकी पुत्र गीतं एको देवो देवकी पुत्र एव एको मंत्रस्तस्य नामानि यानि कर्माप्येकं तस्य देवस्य सेवा सो विथ दीज वर्ड्स आई कन्वे माय ग्रीटिंग्स टू all of you who are present here on the auspicious occasion of Bhagavad Gita Jayanti today. And I'm very happy today that we are meeting on Bhagavad Gita Jayanti today. I appreciate the efforts of Prabhu Dharmayasa, who is sitting somewhere and doing all these exercise, which is very, very difficult to do online, everything. And also sometimes to control the speakers. And this is a great effort. And I'm very happy that in his organization, so many people are participating in this conference. So as we were discussing earlier, this is not the day today to speak much about Bhagavad Gita, but this is a kind of celebration. So we have to share our experiences and happiness to each other and remember Bhagavad Gita, listen to Bhagavad Gita mainly. This is very important today. In Bhagavad Gita, you must have noticed every chapter ends with the word yoga. This is very important. You must have noticed that first chapter is Arjuna Vishada Yoga, then Sankhya Yoga, Karma Yoga, Moksha Sanyasa Yoga, Karma Sanyasa Yoga, Purushottama Yoga. So in every chapter end, there is a word yoga. Why there is a word yoga in the end? So with this, what I am thinking that sage Vyasa, who is the writer of Bhagavad Gita, because Bhagavad Gita is the part of Mahabharata. Mahabharata was written by sage Vyasa. And he, the sage Vyasa, whom we consider the second poet of this world, because Valmiki was the first poet and the Vyasa was the second poet in the world. Before that, there were not poets at all, because these two are very, very ancient epics. So Vyasa says, suggests us that yoga, what is the meaning of yoga? Yujyate iti yoga. So we all are jivatmans, jivas. Once upon a time, in very primitive stage, we were united with the Paramatma, but somehow due to the ignorance, we have detached, separated from Brahma, and we are, because after detaching, after separating from Brahma, we are experiencing all miseries. Why? Because Brahma is the Ananda Swarupa. What kind of Brahma is? Brahma means, what is the definition of Brahma? What Upanishad say about Brahma? Satchit Ananda Swarupa. Sat, Chit and Ananda. Taittiriya Upanishad says very clearly about the Brahman, Ananda Deva Kalvimani Bhutani Jayante. So from that Ananda only all these Bhutas or Jivas are coming. But when we are separated, we started experiencing this ignorance, these miseries. That is why Bhagavad Gita suggests yoga. Again, once again you unite with him. Once again you unite with Paramatma. Only then you will get the real happiness. That is why our original nature is happiness. We must notice this. Our original nature is happiness. That is why, suppose when you are sitting in a room, your friend comes and asks you, why you are sad? He asks you, why you are sad? Are you okay? Are you happy? Why you are sad? Why you are in troubles? Why you are crying? People ask like that because our original nature is not to be sad, not to be unhappy. That is why they ask why you are unhappy. But let us think that on the other day, next day, you are really happy. You don't have any problems and sitting in your room. And can you are just smiling and happy in your room, and can your friend ask you why you are happy today? Why you are not crying? Can he ask like that? He cannot ask, because our original form is to be happy. Our original nature is to be happy. That is why nobody can ask us why you are happy. People ask us why you are unhappy, because our original, why you left your own original nature and became unhappy. So with this yoga word, Sage Vyasa wanted to suggest us, you see, you are part of Brahma. And you have detached and you are separated from Brahma. That is why you have a kind of disease now. This is Dukkha disease. What kind of disease? Me and mine are the two diseases. Me and mine. So with this me and mine disease, you have forgotten your own nature. But what is your original nature? Aham Brahmasmi. I am the Brahma. I am the blissful. I am happy always. That is our original nature. So this is how, this is what Bhagavad Gita suggests us. And Bhagavad Gita, it is not easy to describe the efficacy of Bhagavad Gita through the words, because it is the most sacred and the most secret spiritual text in the world. The essence of four Vedas can be found in Bhagavad Gita. This is the essence of all Vedas and all Upanishads. That is why I said there is a secret spiritual text. Though it possesses such a deep meaning, the language used in Bhagavad Gita is very simple and straightforward. Those who know a little Sanskrit can understand it quickly. But one needs a lifetime to practice the philosophy elucidated in it. The miracle of Bhagavad Gita is, there is a miracle in the Bhagavad Gita. The miracle of Bhagavad Gita is the reciter, those who do Parayana, reciter, gets innovative feelings every day while reciting. Every day you get one innovative, it is not old. Every day you get a new feeling, innovative feeling while reciting. The invariable qualities of Supreme Consciousness are perfectly described in Bhagavad Gita. And that is why the sage Vedavyasa says, after describing Bhagavad Gita, Gita Sugita Kartavya. This is words, these are the words of sage Vyasa in Mahabharata. After Bhagavad Gita, he says, what he says? He says that Gita Sugita Kartavya Kimanyaihi Shastravistarehi Yasvayam Padmanabhasya Mukhapadmat Vinistruta. Because this came directly, Yasvayam Padmanabhasya Mukhapadmat Vinisruta. Vinishruta. Vinishruta means it has come out from Padmanabha's face. Means that directly, because no scripture, God directly is saying, but Bhagavad Gita directly God is saying, that is the peculiarity of Bhagavad Gita. And Bhagavad Gita was spoken by Supreme Padmanabha. So if one reads it, one need not read any other Vedic literature, any other Vedic book, any other book, because it is the gist of all Shastras. Bhagavad Gita is a part of a great Sanskrit epic Mahabharata, and we all know the Mahabharata, Bharatam Panchamo Veda, we say. And whatever is said in Mahabharata, you can find in other places, but the thing which is not described in Mahabharata, you cannot find elsewhere. That is what said in Mahabharata itself. Sri Vyasa says himself, Yadihasti tadanyatra yan nehasti natat kvachit. Whatever is described in Mahabharata, you can find elsewhere. But the thing which is not explained in Mahabharata, you cannot find any other place. That is the greatness of Mahabharata. And also Mahabharata has two peculiarities, because one is Bhagavad Gita is the part of Mahabharata. It is found in Bhishma Parva. And also Mahabharata has the Vishnu Sahasranama in Anushasanika Parva. So these two texts, and also there are many other texts, the Yaksha Prashnas also are there in Mahabharata. So Vishnu Sahasranama is there, Anushasana Parva, and Bhishma Parva, we have Bhagavad Gita. So that is why Bharatam Panchamo Veda. So that is why Mahabharata is very important. So now, coming to the our Gita Jayanti, we don't have much time to explain all these things, but this is what we are remembering Gita. Remembering Gita is very important today. That is why I'm not elaborating. Gita Shastram Idam Punyam Yap Patet Prayatah Vishnu Padam Avapno Bhaya Shoka Adivarjitah. This is what Vishnu Padam Avapno Bhaya Shoka Adivarjitah. The one who reads Bhagavad Gita, he will not have fear, and he will not have any misery, any problem in his life. So Bhagavad Gita, that is why Shankaracharya says, no need to read entire Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita, kinchid adhita. Kinchid adhita, Shankaracharya says, even little bit you read Bhagavad Gita, you will get the emancipation, moksha. And Bhagavad Gita says, you should try for the moksha. But you should understand what is moksha. Because just now also we were telling moksha. Today I found very interesting verse in Yoga Vashishta. That was also written by Valmiki only. Ramayana also was written by Valmiki. Yoga Vashishta also was written. Because whatever Vashishta's advice to Rama, Vashishta's teaching to Rama, is Yoga Vasishta. Valmiki has recorded in Yoga Vasishta all his advices, all his teachings of Vasishta to Rama. So Vasishta says to Rama, so what is moksha? Don't worry about the moksha, because moksha is nothing but to be very happy, to realize God within you. God is nowhere else. You see, na moksho nabhasa purshte. Moksha is not there anywhere in the sky. Patale nacha bhutale. Moksha is
sorry,
not
Prabhu, kindly conclude your speech, please.
Also in Bhutala. So moksha is to be very happy, to realize God within you. So that is what the Bhagavad Gita says. So now I'm very happy to meet all of you, and I conclude my speech here. Thank you. Dhanyavad.
Thank you so much, Prof. It is certainly very, very inspiring, and of course very difficult to make it brief in 5 minutes, the 700 verse of Bhagavad Gita. Well, of course, Professor Rao reminded us about the origin of happiness. So thank you so much for this. As Bhagavad Gita is a sacred spiritual text, let's make it live in our body and our mind forever. So with this as I said, we have to strike 5 minutes given the time by the committee. I would like to express our appreciation if the rest of the speaker can strike the time for 5 minutes. Of course, we are very happy with those very inspiring speech. Now I give the floor to Dr. Diles Ok from United States of America. Dr. Ok, you have the floor.
Namaskar, thank you. And
Hari Pada Prema Dhananda Abhanoda.